this occasion to celebrate a seminal event in American history.
This year, we depict perhaps the most important day in our shared past, the first Thanksgiving.
A day for maize, the Native American word for corn, a terrific turkey dinner, and brotherhood. So, white meat and dark meat, take it away!
Let him come into this house.
Too late now.
Greetith the Mundo.
What can I do for you, Master Fonz?
Oh, great blacksmith, I need a new part. 'Tis my brakes again. Mistresses, thank ye, thank ye. Inspiration rock. Two turns of the hourglass. Be there.
Master Arthur, will you sup with us?
Oh, thank ye, but nay ye. I got a res to sup with the Standish triplets.
These colonial fires, they're not like they were in England.
Well, good Dame Cunningham, I'll take care of that.
No need, no need. Stand back.
Hail, farewell, and
Lois.
What's wrong with my gravy?
Oh, nothing, except you could walk across the skin on top of it.
Oh, well, I'm sorry, Julia Child. Here's your perfect piece. Oh, look, I spilled one. Sorry.
Thank you. Norm, I'm sorry about what I said about your gravy.
All right.
It's okay. Fine. So are the carrots.
Anybody want some of these lovely yams? Woody, would you care to test the gravy skin?
Never been witness to such a silly, soft. Sam Malone, kiss your butt goodbye!
So good, huh?
I hear hundreds of people who have gathered to witness what has been described as perhaps the greatest turkey event in Thanksgiving Day history. All we know for sure is that in a very few moments there are going to be a lot of happy people out here. Now, the crowd is curious, but well-behaved. And I think I hear something now. The crowd is moving out into the parking area. And, oh yes, I can see it now.
It's a helicopter.
And it's coming this way.
A helicopter?
It's flying something behind it. I can't quite make it out. It's a large banner. And it says, Happy Thanksgiving. Gentlemen, what a sight. The copter seems to be circling the parking area now. I guess it's looking for a place to land. No, something just came out of the back of the helicopter. It's a dark object. Perhaps a skydiver plummeting to the earth from only 2,000 feet in the air. Third. So no parachutes yet.
Skydivers. I can't tell just yet what they are, but...
Oh, my God, they're talking! Oh, Johnny, can you get this? Oh, they're crashing to the earth right in front of my eyes! The wind just went through the windshield of a parked car! This is terrible. The car is running around, pushing each other. Oh, my goodness! Oh, the humanity! Oh, people are running about. The turkeys are hitting the ground like sacks of wet cement. Running for their lives. I think I'm going to step inside. I can't stay out here and watch this anymore. No, I can't go in there.
The children are searching for their mothers, and oh, not since the Hindenburg tragedy has there been anything like this. I don't know how much longer I can hold my position here, Johnny. The crowd.
Les, are you there? Les isn't there. Thanks for that on-the-spot report, Les. You just tuned in. The Pinedale Shopping Mall has just been bombed with live turkeys. Film at 11.
Oh, this is terrific. Tomorrow night we'll have a big Thanksgiving dinner.
Thanksgiving? But that was last week.
Yeah, when daylight saving time ends, you're supposed to set your clocks back, not your calendars.
Well, when we found out you were coming, we figured, why settle for one Thanksgiving? Now that you're all here, we can have a second one tomorrow.
Oh, right. Let's have two Thanksgivings and two Christmases, quickly followed by two birthday parties. Do it twice, because presents are nice.
That's right, Arnold. And I'll cook the turkey for tomorrow night. Ruth and Ann can help me stuff it.
I know how to stuff a turkey. Just give Willis a big meal.
Cool it, Arnold, or I'll show you how to stuff a brother.
One more chance. Here is your turkey carving practice cabbage.
Dad, that's a cabbage.
Right. You're brilliant. You know, I watched you last night and what you did to that chicken. You see, a long time ago, before you were born, I prayed that God would give me a son to carry on the family name. And you were born. And I've watched you do things. And many times, I've wanted to ask you not to tell anyone who you are. And last night was one of those times. You're supposed to respect the food, you understand? Slice it in an appetizing manner. Now, let me explain to you how you should slice a turkey properly. You take the blade gently in your hand, and you slice ever so gently, following the brain, going along the contour of the bed.
Dad?
Yes?
Why are you talking like that?
I had no idea. Except it just makes me feel more secure when I'm in the kitchen. Now, try it, my boy. And talk it through.
I follow the natural contour of the flavor.
Yes.
And the follow the grain of the flour. Look at it.
Yes.
And slice.
Yes.
And
slice. Excuse me, boy.
Yes.
In the
past few days, we've all heard of the benefits of intrarectogestion, and so making foods that can easily be inserted into the ass is essential. Now, everyone knows that some foods are simple to shove up the ass, puddings, soups, raisins. This is a nice raisin pudding right here. But we can also still eat our favorite foods. What we're going to do today is prepare a Thanksgiving turkey for intrarecto. Now, the key to shoving a turkey up your ass is first wrapping it in string, keeping the pointy wings neatly at the side.
Mrs. Stewart, we have some questions.
Not right now. I just want to focus on my turkey right now. Now, we're going to baste the turkey with lubricating gel rather than with juice. This will help smooth the insertion later on. We still bake at 400 degrees for 20 minutes a pound. When it's done, we'll get something like this. So now we're ready to go. Looks delicious. Let's try it out. Oh. Oh. Yeah, get it up there. Yeah. Ah. Yeah. Ah. Whew. And that is how you eat a turkey. We'll be right back with more.
Turkey on Thanksgiving. This could catch on.
Kelly, look at the nice bed we made for Hank.
Listen, honey, when he's all snuggled in, we'll kiss him goodbye. I meant good night. And then we're gonna put him into his little house.
Well, I don't know if he's gonna like it. Hank's afraid of the dark.
Oh, but see, if I turn this little dial, his house fills up with a pretty blue light. Yeah, and he'll be real comfy sleeping on these breadcrumbs.
And honey, I made him a blanket. Wait a minute. I know what you guys are trying to do. You're trying to get Hank to like you more than me. Well, I am sorry. We're too smart to fall for that.
All right, look, this is what we're going to do. I'll distract her while you snap the neck. Couldn't you snap her neck? And after all, she is my sister. I can't.
Kelly, honey, I'm getting a little concerned. Yeah, you're getting very attached to Hank, and the lifespan of a turkey is very short.
Especially this time of year. Kelly, what are you doing? These are my pants.
I know, but you and Hank are about the same size. What are you doing with your hands around Hank's neck?
Oh, he's checking his pulse. he doesn't look too good.
Could be turkey pox.
Maybe we should check his temperature with this.
Yeah. First, we better take off his feathers and examine him.
Wait a minute. I know what you guys are up to. You just want to see Hank naked.
Hanky, your bubble bath's ready.
Okay, let's kill him.
Hanky, Pookie, are you down here?
Hey, what are you doing?
Oh, this is ridiculous. Kelly, look, I know you love Hank, so I'm going to say this as gently as possible. We're gonna cut that bird's head off, stuff his butt full of bread, and eat him.
Get away! Get away! You are not gonna kill Hank!
Kelly, honey, it's your mother. You know I'm on your side. How many heart-to-hearts have we had through this door?
Mom, that's the linen closet.
We have a linen closet?
Open up! You turkey haters!
Kelly, I promise he won't feel a thing.
This isn't one of your dates, bud.
I'm sorry, Hank. I really want to keep you, but it's not safe here. I'm gonna have to set you free. Oh, me too. I'll never forget you. Fly away, Hank! Fly like the wind!
Ditto. Duh.
Jefferson, thanks for my Thanksgiving turkey.
Oh, well, you really have to thank Kelly. I mean, she's the one who threw him to his neck snapping death.
I'm so sorry, Hank.
You're talking into his butt.